This is a case shared by Dr. David Cordeiro Sousa from Melbourne, Australia. This is a case of a 27-year-old male with a history of worsening the visual acuity in the right eye 10 days ago. His best corrected visual acuity on presentation was count finger in the right eye and 6/12 in the left eye, and the IOP was 3 mm of mercury in OD. In the slit lamp examination, he had a superotemporally subluxated white cataract in both eyes. The fundus examination in OD was difficult because of medium opacities, but it was possible to see a retinal detachment associated with giant retinal tear with macula involved. And the B-scan ultrasound OD evidenced a retinal detachment associated with choroidal effusion. In the beginning of the surgery, we can notice that the lens was very mobile. The surgeon started the procedure performing lensectomy using an anterior chamber maintainer due to the choroidal effusion. During the vitrectomy, it's possible to see a total retinal detachment associated with a giant retinal tear superotemporally. The retina was very mobile with anterior folds and ciliary body detachment. In these cases, it's important to be careful during trimming of the vitreous base to avoid iatrogenic breaks. Using a scleral depressor, the surgeon is able to safely remove the vitreous from the base using parameters with high cut rates and low vacuum. It's also important to remove the anterior flap of the giant retinal tear in these cases. Brilliant blue dye was used to stain the internal luminal membrane and to ensure that there weren't areas of remnant posterior hyaloid still attached. After finishing the shaving of the base, the surgeon decided to place an encircling band. So, a circumferential conjunctivoperitomy was made, the muscles were isolated, and then the infusion line was changed to the persplana. A 240 scleral band was placed then 6 mm behind the insertion of the muscles using scleral tunnel technique. The advantage of this technique is that you are able to place a buckle without using Merceland sutures, usually faster than the suture technique. However, one has to take care about the width of the incision created by the crescent blade to prevent scleral perforation. After passing the buckle into the four sulcus in all quadrants and behind the muscles, the band is tied using a standard sleeve. As following, the perfluorocarbon liquid was used to flat the retina, and endolaser was made circumferentially around the area of giant retinal tear and of the scleral indentation. The fluid air exchange was made without retinal slippage, and we can see better under air an area of choroidal detachment temporally. Before fluid air exchange, the surgeon performed an inferior iridotomy. The buccal indentation was tightened under air and silicone oil was implanted at the end of the vitrectomy. So the truncus were removed, the silicone oil bubbles washed, and then scleral conjunctival sutures were made. The patient improved the visual acuity after 1 month to 6/30, and this is the aspect of the retina in the mouth free.